What's up, guys? Talk Movies with us here, back again for another movie review. And we just got back from seeing the latest entry in the MCU.
Yes.
Thor Ragnarok.
Starring Chris Hemsworth,
Tom Hiddleston, and Mark Ruffalo. So, a quick little summary. A mysterious character named Hela comes into the picture and threatens Thor's homeland of Asgard. And in the midst of all this stuff going on, he gets transported into another land with Loki, run by Jeff Goldblum. He is the leader of this mysterious planet, I guess we would call it, right?
Yeah. Then he has to escape that planet, go save Asgard. In the midst, we get a ton of action, a ton of comedy, a ton of MCU characters that we really didn't know were in this movie.
Yes, a lot of nice surprises, and an epic battle between Thor and the Hulk, man.
Yes.
And this is obviously in the trailer. There's no spoiler here. I wish they would have kept it out of the trailer.
That would have been awesome.
It would have been a nice surprise, but either way, that was an awesome scene.
It was so epic. And there's just like a scene towards the end of the fight where, you know, Thor gets all pumped up and it's just, it's so good.
It was probably one of the best fights in all of the MCU, I would say. It was so epic. And Chris Hemsworth owns the role of Thor, right? He's great in this.
And he's not too bad to look at either.
I guess so. And
he gets his hair cut in this movie.
And let me tell you something. One of the biggest positives, not one of the, but it's a positive for me, is that I feel like they made Thor a lot less cheesy looking.
He looks so badass.
He looks really badass. They cut that hair, man. They
smeared the red on his face for the fight scene with the Hulk, and it was just...
It was a much improved look. I like how they mixed it up a little bit.
The other performances as well. I mean, the character for Hela, she was great. She was very...
Very good. Very Circe, but over the top, if you get what I'm saying. Tom Hiddleston, of course, plays that, you know, who the hell is this guy? Can you trust him? Can you not trust him? Is he an asshole? You don't really know. Yeah, he does a good job as well, you know?
I know. You really just don't know whether you want to like him or not like him.
I know.
It's a constant back and forth. I mean, in every single movie that he's in.
And of course, Jeff Goldblum was just awesome, right? Jeff Goldblum, but he's...
His performance was really solid for a character that kind of was a main character, but not really. He really, like, the scenes that he was in, he stole the show.
And of course, he's just the king of being quirky. Mark Ruffalo, of course, is great as the Hulk, right?
Yep, he's definitely one of the best Hulks we've seen. And he, I mean, the comedy in this movie, just to kind of talk about that, it plays so well into each and every character, including the Hulk. Like, I was laughing hysterically during all of his scenes.
That's where I have a problem with this movie, I will say, is everything about it is epic and awesome. The fight scenes are great. The acting, the performances are really good for what you can expect from an MCU movie. But I felt like the comedy was very heavy-handed in this. And that goes for all MCU. And that's my biggest gripe with MCU and these Marvel movies is I wish the comedy was a little more subtle. I would say the comedy works maybe like 70-30. I would say 70% of it works. I'll say there's like 30% that for me didn't hit.
I mean, I can see why you would say that, and I feel like the MCU, just like over time, has gotten more lighthearted and more comedic. And for me, it's not a problem. I do think some of it is a little bit forced. I didn't feel that way in this movie at all. I feel like they did go the route of Guardians of the Galaxy with the music and the bright colors and all of that, and I feel like it worked. I think that this is the best Thor movie yet.
Oh, I will give it that 100%.
Yes. So,
and the director of this movie is definitely a Led Zeppelin fan. I couldn't help but think of the School of Rock, but a lot of, you know, nice Led Zeppelin tracks in there with the incorporated into these huge battle sequences, and it was really fun to watch.
And visually, this movie for me was absolutely stunning. We were able to see it in the Dolby Theater, and between the sound and the colors and everything, it was, and the CGI was great.
Yeah, it was really
good. I have no complaints on the CGI, and sometimes, you know, CGI gets a little questionable, but for me, I mean, overall, this movie was just amazing.
Yeah,
it was amazing.
It was extremely colorful. It was really good. It was very visually fun to look at, as the rest of these MCU movies are, you know? And they fall into that category where, like, they try to appeal to everybody, I feel like, you know what I mean? With the comedy, the action, you know? They do a nice job. I would say, like I said, comedy is a little much, but I know it didn't ruin the experience for me at all. And this is really a solid Marvel film. I loved it. I really did.
So, would you put it ahead of Spider-Man and Guardians of the Galaxy 2?
Definitely Spider-Man Homecoming. I did not like Spider-Man Homecoming, really. The more I think about it, the more I didn't like it. Guardians of the Galaxy, to me, the comedy in that film works a little more for me because there's more characters. More back and forth and more banter between multiple characters, where in this one, it's, you know, Thor, you know, Loki, the chick, or whatever, and you know, and the Hulk. You know, it runs a little dry for me, the comedy. But it does, most of it works, but they just, you know, I feel like it takes the stakes out of it. I feel like, you know, you're in this moment, you're in this epic battle, and then some stupid joke, that some running gag throughout the whole movie, and it kind of takes you out of it, in a sense. That's how I feel, kind of. But like I said, I don't want to sound like I'm bashing this film for that, because I really loved it. That was just my only gripe with it, is...
Like, if you had to have something you didn't like about it. All right, so do we want to grade it?
Sure.
I am going to give it an A-. I think it's definitely the best Thor movie that we've seen. And I think that despite me loving Guardians of the Galaxy 2 and Spider-Man Homecoming, and obviously Logan, but that's a whole completely different Marvel movie.
Without a doubt.
I definitely enjoyed this one more than those two. So, A-.
A-, yeah, I'm gonna go B+.
Okay.
As I described it in the Stardust app, which is where we film our reactions right after walking out of the movie, before we get to the set and start filming.
Yep.
I described it as a little bit of Game of Thrones, a little bit of Gladiator, and of course that Marvel comedy and that
epicness,
and incorporated into one. And it was a really fun movie, and I really enjoyed the hell out of it, man.
Yeah.
Thor is a total badass, jacked up. God, I gotta start working out. And I will say, guys, the after credits scene, I mean, you don't even need to stay for them. Like, they are a complete waste.
I don't think so. They were never... It's the fun of it.
I guess, but if you got a piss and you want to leave the theater, go ahead. Don't even... Because I had to pee really bad, so I was sitting there like, oh, come on. And, like, for nothing. So, I mean,
at least it wasn't Captain America trolling you.
Yeah, that's true. It didn't insult me as much as that one did. But, yeah, just a little tidbit for you guys. That is our review of Thor Ragnarok.
Thank you guys so much, as always, for watching our reviews. Give this video a big thumbs up. Like, comment, and subscribe.
And let us know what your favorite MCU movie thus far is. Let us know in the comments down below. And we'll see you guys on the next video.
See you guys later.